1,000 years old.
Happy to say that Ireland, or at least Dublin, got its railway station before London. And this is the first railway station to be built in Ireland. It was formerly known as Westland Row, but in 1916. The highest planning authority in the country said, no, sorry, it's a listed building. If you want to develop the land, you must incorporate your building into the circular structure. Now, just to my left hand side is that peninsula across the bay is HWTH. There's just something else I want to explain. Irish and Scotland. This marks the southern terminus of the first railway between Dublin. So this was the terminus of the line. And this is the terminus of what is now Ireland got independence. They reverted back to the older name of Dúdaliri, and today it's called Dúdaliri. Autographs later. From Leary or Dúdaliri. It sold for $5.9 million, $6 million in 1990. That at the time was about $8.5 million. But this guy was prepared to pay for the view here. Right here. The promenade is a very special called Esplanade. Do you see it? And as the railway curves around to the left, you'll be able to get it. Just remember, I don't mean to patronise when I say a little bit of gunpowder and inexpensive, so you'll find for example t-shirts and colours.
Yeah, that's what I
want.
Yeah.
Plaid design.
Okay.
You're familiar with plaid.
We're going now past the Bard Cafeteria. To see you all get to the front of time, the very front of time, well down about 4 minutes. We're going to have all past us, the Bard Cafeteria, to see you all the front
of time. Thank you. South to the south side. Heritage from the south side. Now that's a Gorev Mahagut.
Well, folks, welcome aboard. We're heading on down to the meeting of the waters and Ballycus Angel. And of course, he missed the House of Commons. So much so that his health deteriorated. And when he went to his local physician, he said to him that he'd have to go to France where there was a sunny climate because the wet climate wasn't doing his health any good. So the jury went to France and he died on the 23rd of December 1891. So I'm telling you the story about him. He was a great orator, a great speech maker in the House of Commons, so much so that the House of Parliament was always packed when he was giving a speech. He was very self-conscious of saying, he put his hands behind his back, putting the fingers of his hands into the palm of his hands, and when he was, by the time he was like walking, hill walking, don't forget to mention the Wicklow Way around this area. And I was mentioning on the train about all the forests. You're paying for all them and you give it back. So after 20 years, folks, you get for all the trees that's there, you get that. And then it's refurbished and chimney, that was the shaft, that was the steam chimney there, and that used to bring the lift the people right down into the mine. It was a copper mine, by the way, folks, and of course, like all mines, once it stops making money and it's exhausted, the people, there's no fish life, bird life, or animal life, folks. And seeing how clear it was up there when you were at the meeting of the waters. So watch out when you go into a bogey, you'll see the brown stains of the rocks, and they're that's the copper coming down the river, folks. We'd see it now in a few moments. Because the priest never charged your television license rent up last year. We're on down on the bus, there's only one train, and there's another one tonight at half. And this is Hendley's here. Hendley's is still Hendley's, and it was Hendley. You can buy a few gifts in all the little shops there, folks. And you can get a postcard and tell them you're the. Thank you.
Thank you.